Hi, Mr. Awadallah. This is Marcia at Sennholtz, and I am in BIO165-I5. I will never forgive you for this. I feel very awkward. The lady here at JCC was kind enough to let me have a back room and one of the microscopes so I could do this and not feel like quite such a fool. So anyway, I'm here to describe the microscope and the camera may jump around a little bit because I have to hold it. But anyway, and hello fellow students, it's nice to meet all of you, and I am looking forward to working with each of you. Okay, here we have our standard microscope, and the pieces on it are your first piece up here on the top is your ocular lens or eyepiece, and that can come in different magnifications. This one is a 15x magnification, and then you have your focal tube, eyepiece tube, body tube, is called several different things. Then we've got the nose piece, or I also found it's called the objective turret, and these are the objectives. These are your magnifying pieces. They will come in different magnifications. The way to get your magnification is you take whatever power objective lens you have. Let's say if you're using a 40x here, and you multiply it times the ocular lens, and this is a 15x, so this would be a 600x magnification on that. The next thing you have is your coarse adjustment tube. Coarse adjustment knob, and this is what you do to make your first adjustments. You always adjust up away from the slide. You start in the lowest position and always go up. Once you get it into view, then you will use the fine focus knob here to bring it the resolution in to make it clear. This is the arm and the base, and this is what you would carry, how you would carry the microscope. You would grasp one hand around the arm and the other hand underneath the base to carry it to be safe. The next thing you have is the stage. This is where the lens will go that has the specimen on it. These are the stage clips to hold the lens in place. This little screw is a stop screw that is to keep you from lowering it too far and breaking the lens that you're looking through, which could be a safety hazard. A lot of microscopes, the better microscopes, the stage will adjust back and forth so that you can bring your specimen in the field of view that you need. Underneath is the diaphragm, which allows the amount of light to come in, depending upon how much light you need to see whatever particular specimen. This has a light underneath here, and I call it illumination field or a puck light. I don't think the puck lights I saw didn't look like this, so I'm not sure what this one particular one would be called. Or also a mirror is used, and then, I don't think there's not a mirror on this one, but you could use a mirror to reflect in the light to come up and let you see the specimen that you have. And I believe that is it. I don't believe I forgot anything. If I did, sorry. But as I said, this is a little awkward, but it's nice to seeing each of you. And if you would do me a huge favor, there's my phone. If you would let me know as soon as this goes off for YouTube, or as soon as you see it, let me know so I can take it off of YouTube, because I don't want to be a viral video, okay? Anyway, I hope to enjoy this class. You're a great teacher so far, and I'm just looking forward to it. Take care. Bye.